Hey guys, it's PrimeScore from Shockbite, and today I'm going to show you how to use permissions for your Minecraft server. So, what does permissions do? So, permissions gives permission to certain players to do certain actions that you specify. For example, if you have admins on your server and then regular players, and let's say donators, so you got three groups. You want the admins to do all the administrative work, like modding or monitoring, like moderating. Banning people and whatnot, but you don't want regular players to do that because then you just have people banning other people. And for your donators, you want your donators to have special access to certain items or whatever you want donators to be. And so what permissions does is that it allows certain users to do certain things. So if we have an admin group on our permissions, whatever we specify, anybody who is an admin can do those actions, but anybody who's a regular user cannot do those actions. First, you're going to want to install permissions X. That's the one I'm going to be showing you today. There's other ones called lucky perms. But today I'm going to show you how to set up permissions using permissions X, the most basic way. So first, once you've installed your Permissions X plugin, you're going to generate a file called permissions right here. And it's going to look exactly like this if it's your first time installing it. So it's only going to create a default group. And you can change the name whatever you want, as long as the option default is set to true. If this option is set to true under your default or any class, this will be their default class. So I could name this banana. As long as this is true, everyone will be the banana class on their first login. And here's all the permissions that the default class has. So let's say this is awesome, perfect, but we want to have an admin class so people can use WorldEdit, for example. So to create a new group, we're going to type in admin colon and then enter, and then if we want other options we can do so, but we're going to keep it basic right now, and we're just going to type in permissions and then enter, and then we're going to do a backspace, and then you want to do a dash, and then you're going to type in the permission you want to grant an admin. And so one for world edit, I'm going to give the admin access to any world edit command. And to do that, I'm going to type in world edit dot and star. Every plugin you download that has permissions has a list of the permissions you can utilize. So I went to the world edit page, looked at the permission that grants all commands to whoever has that permission. Usually, always, if it has the plugin name dot star, that means that everything within that group will be accessed. So everything within the world edit permissions will be granted to this person in just one line, instead of you having to do world edit dot wand and world edit dot whatever for every single thing. So that single permission will grant access to admins, who's ever in the group admin, permission to use world edit, which is awesome. That's what we want. If we save this, go to your FTP, and I'm just going to upload it to my server. Once that's done uploading, I'm going to restart the server. Don't do slash reload. That is very bad for your server. Once your server's done restarting, we'll go in. And then I won't have access. I'm still a default user because every time I log in, I'm put into the default class because that's what this says. Now, if I wanted, I could delete this option and put it under here and everyone would become an admin. But that's a terrible idea. And so if I try to do slash wand, I'm not allowed to do that, even though there's a permission, but I'm not an admin. And so to do that, to give people permissions, we're going to do it via a command. You can also type it into the permission file, but as you can see in here, there's no section for like users. Well, if you know how to set that up, then you can easily type it in. But if you don't, what you want to initially do is type in pex space group space, and then the group you want to give the user. So I want to give me the admin group, and then you're going to type in user add, and then you're going to type in the username, which is PrimeScore. Then I'm going to enter that, and it says user PrimeScore added to admin. Awesome. Now I can, if I type in slash wand, it works. I have access to it. I am now an admin. So to see the changes we did in this, we're going to exit out of that. Refresh this, and then I'm going to download the new file. When we did that, it edited the permissions file. So now we're going to open this, and we're going to see what it added. As you can see, what we had before is right here. It looks exactly the same, but now there's a new users section. This is just the unique user ID of the person. This is the group that they belong to. They can belong to many different groups at once. And the options name, that's just my display name. That's the basic workings of permissions. And there's a lot of options you can utilize when using permissions. So I have a huge, this is from one of my older servers. This is my permissions that I use. The default class I called it default. And here is all the permissions for my default class, which is awesome. Usually it's all essential stuff and some other stuff too. Now here's some options. Default, obviously I want that true because that's the default class. Now there's another option called prefix. And what that does is that if you have something that supports the prefix option for permissions X, such as essentials, which I do have installed, as you can see. When you set this, this will be the prefix, or you can use the option suffix of the user's display name in chat. So since it's AND7 for me, all that is just the color code. So that just changes the player's name color when they type in chat. Now, there's another thing to permissions, and it's called inheritance. And what that essentially means is that the group defined in the inheritance, all of those permissions will be given to the person being inherited. So for example, as you can see, I have a donator rank, and it's going to inherit everything from the default rank. So this right here says it's going to take all of these permissions and add it to the donator rank. So I don't have to copy and paste it all into here, which makes life so much easier. Here's the list of all of the permissions that my donators will get. And as you can see, I have these stars at the end, which just gives access to all of the permissions within the Echo Pet type creeper. Now this is an older server. I don't know if that plugin still works, but yeah. And as you can see, I have an option for a prefix, which will override the other prefix to give them the donator prefix I have. And then I have moderators. And so they're going to inherit everything a donator has, because that's what I do on my server. And then they're going to get all of these, and then it's going to change the prefix. And so I have that for everything. And now when we go to the user section, you can see this user has a custom prefix, which you can do, of mod plus. And his name is Syncope. Yeah, that's his name. And then he's the head moderator. And then we have another user who's a donator, and that's his name. And then that's pretty much what it usually does throughout. So under users, you can pretty much use the same options as you do in the groups above. So I can give this single user a specific permission if I wanted to. And so I give them permission to use all permissions X commands. And of course, it's the owner, and this is me right here. And so that's pretty much it. When you're wanting to set up permissions. Now, there is something else in permissions. There's another option. Let's say that I have this awesome default class, and I got donators, but I want my donators not to have access to the TP deny command. And to do that, I'm going to go under my permissions, go under here, type in the exact permission, and if I put a dash in front of it, you can think of it like a minus sign. It's going to remove this permission from this group. The donator will not have access to this permission because I have that dash in front of it. That's very useful if you trying to micromanage some weird situation. Otherwise, that's exactly how permissions should be set up. This is a pretty basic guide, but it should get you started, and you should completely understand how to set up permissions on your server. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments section below. Otherwise, have a great day. And thank you for watching.